Upcoming company, female-owned company, youth company, and we basically do corporate branding and general supplies. General supplies includes things like supplies of things like toilet paper, your day-to-day necessities, things like cleaning products, and all of that.
Well, you know what? I think when a lot of people start businesses, obviously, the one thing that comes to their mind is finance. There's this saying that business is about making profits. Okay. But actually, finance is the end product, because before you even get finance, you need to actually have a value proposition. You need to have identified a market. And for me, a market really is like, what problem am I trying to solve?
My business is, it involves hair salon and projects. The motive behind this business was to give a woman a platform to use their hobbies to turn their hobbies into business. Because what I've realized that is that most of the women take themselves for granted simply because of they don't have certain qualifications and they never had a chance to go to school. So of which there's something that they can do best. So I just wanted to give them a platform so that they can do their best.
Yes, please.
So you're gonna have it yet, Gala?
No, we will tell you.
Tasasa, which is actually the first company that I started with after being employed in the mining industry for about over 7 years. I registered Tasasa in 2011, that's when I resigned and then started operating. My main aim, firstly, is to appreciate what the support that I got, which is obviously the funding from IDC, and also to network with various people who are attending the conference.
So what we basically do, we help companies to engage effectively with their stakeholders. We help companies to mediate if there are challenges within their partnership or with their communities, to actually mediate as opposed to going through legal processes and spending a lot of money. So that's one of the things we do. But we also help companies to engage effectively and communicate with their hardest to reach stakeholders. So it could be your low-level employees who may not necessarily understand some of the big terms that you use within your organization, but you have critical business, critical information that you want to talk to them about. We help you communicate effectively there. Or it could be your communities or external stakeholders.
What we've basically got our main focus on is building maintenance. We've got three divisions within the business. We've got an electrical maintenance business unit, we've got a plumbing maintenance business unit, and then we've got a normal building maintenance business unit. So that's basically what we're focusing on.
Yeah.
I said I've never been formally employed. I started the business, officially registered in my second year of studies at University of Johannesburg, and then I started actually trading while I was actually studying. So we got to the point of to pursue the business and pursue the entrepreneurship journey in as opposed to going to look for a job.
My challenge to the government and the CEO that are here is, let us take this platform and ensure that there are fruits and not comfort.